close enough.
How do you like it so far? It's a pretty good song, isn't it?
Yeah.
Want to hear it again?
Takeoff style, and Red told me to come up in here and say, you guys can take off.
Randall, come on.
It's time for us to play. Thank you.
Your time is coming, but it's not yet.
You're not going to get paid this week, you guys. $5 you could have had, it's gone now. Forget it. That's it. I can't believe they would do such a thing to us. Imagine our dignity besmirched by having to stand there and look at you.
They haven't figured out that they still work for us yet. Anybody else like to come on stage and do something really silly?
Yeah, you're doing fine. Go ahead, man.
Yeah, I'll just keep on doing it then. Well, folks, we're having fun.
Georgia Girl is a big accomplishment this last year. There's a company called AEI Music. Anybody ever hear of that? They're sort of a Muzak equivalent. And we're on it this year. They did several bluegrass programs to probably play in fast food restaurants to get people to finish their meal as quickly as possible. And we got several cuts on it, and we're really proud of that. And not to mention the billions and billions of dollars that come from things like that. And we're going to be counting that now in the back room, and going to have the Trailblazers come out. And as you saw, they kind of blew their chance to kind of make any money this week because they disobeyed us again. This has happened quite frequently, and this is one of the things that's led to the breakup of our organization, and there's just nothing we can do about it. They just won't behave, and that's that. So we're just going to drive up to Alaska. We have this little thing where we're telling we're going on tour in Alaska. We're just going to have them do the loadout, and then we're going to leave. Don't tell them. Are there any questions about the Trailblazers? Some people really wonder about them. I wonder about them. I don't know if I know any of the answers, but if you have any questions, I'd be glad to.
Are they going to go on by themselves?
They're going to go on by themselves? Who cares? I don't know.
What's their plan? $20.
The $20? I don't know. I have to see Nick about that. If you're a big guy, would you like to come with me?
Has Waldo got any political ambitions?
Waldo political ambitions. And he's still old enough to be president, as far as I know. So that's an important qualification right there. And he was born in the U.S. That's another important qualification. I guess I'm going to be here for a while. When is Slade going to make an album? Well, I guess there's no better way to get that answered than to put the question to Slade himself. Excuse me? A gospel album. You mean, oh my God, it's the Trailblazers. Please make them welcome one more time, Red Knuckles and the Trailblazers.
Thank you very much, really. Mighty fine. Listen to the echo. There have been some reports of false true Trailblazers frequenting the stage, and we're here to assure you that the true Trailblazers have now taken the stage, and we will present the true music in a way that is truly meant to be done. Thank you so much. I'm Red Knuckles. And they're the fabulous Trailblazers. He is, anyway. A tune called Waiting for Waldo. I'd like to do a song by the... No, I better not. I have the words here to a song. It was a dreadful noise. And like a bullet in the back, I feel like running away and never turning back. Barbados! Thank you. I think that was a good song, but I think you got it wrong. Actually, this is a song called Waiting on Waldo. Here he is now. He's been late to every show. Hey!
Hey! Jimmy Checker!
He almost got his skateboard out, ladies and gentlemen. This is the early prototype skateboard. We're going to do a song now.
We're going to do more than one song, ladies and gentlemen. Red's just being kind of laid back.
That's right, I'm going to be a little bit laid back. Here's one from Al Dexter. It's called Pistol Packin' Mama. I want to tick, tick, four, I want to tick, tick. caught me right, and now I'm on the run. Lay that pistol down, girl, lay that pistol down. Hide that pistol back in mama, lay that pistol down. In my windshield, whomped me over the head. Cursed and cried and said I'd lied and wished that I was dead. Yeah, lay that pistol down, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing, mama, lay that pistol down. The lights and bang, that bomb is gone. Lay that pistol down, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing, mama, lay that pistol down. Every day, I'll be your regular daddy. Just put your gun away. Lay that pistol down, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing, mama, lay that pistol down.
Mr. Red
Knuckles, he liked to have his fun, until with lead she shot him dead. Now his honking days are done. Lay that pistol down, lay that pistol down. Boxing, pistol packing, mama, lay that pistol down. Whoa, lay that pistol down, lay that pistol down, that pistol down. Whoa, pistol packing, mama, lay that pistol down.
As Reba McEntire would say, thank you so much. Really, no, please. Mighty fine. We're going to do an oldie but moldie. And this is one from Hank Williams. And, of course, I never knew this, but he's Hank Williams Jr.'s father. Interesting. How do you like the tuning so far?
Ladies and gentlemen, Red is a professional musician, and as such, he always tries to be in tune whenever possible to provide you, the audience, with the best music possible here in our United States of America. Thank you. It's a beautiful thing, isn't it, Wendell?
Speaking of beautiful things, Waldo, how's the business up there at the donut shop going on?
Oh, it's mighty crunchy, Wendell.
You've been gone for quite some time.
I haven't, you know, so the people come there and they're going, donuts, and it's locked, so they can't get in. So then they just lie around in the gutter in front of it, and they wait for me. And meanwhile, the donuts are getting crunchier and crunchier, I'm telling you. Should we play a little bit of that, you're going to change, or I'm going to leave, or I might even leave even if you don't change?
Okay, well, no, thank you for introducing the song. That's right, it's called, You're Going to Change, or I'm Going to Leave.
A brand new trunk, packing and unpacking your junk. Your daddy's mad, he doesn't got peace. You're gonna change, you're ever gonna leave. You got to change your wicked lip, you to change the things you do. Quit doing them things that you ought to do. Your daddy's mad, he doesn't got peace. You're gonna change, you're ever gonna leave. Every mad, you pack your things, you go home to bed, and tell him lies he can't believe. You're gonna change or am I gonna leave? You wanna make a woman happy, gotta treat her right. Love her every morning, call her out at night. Your daddy's mad, he don't got peace. And you keep a nagging me all day long. You gotta stop, and I don't mean please. You're gonna change, or am I gonna leave? You change the way you live, and you change your thing. You do better doing the things you oughtn't to. Your daddy's mad, he done got peace. You're gonna change, or am I gonna leave? Of course, most of you folks know the members of the Trailblazers, but while we're talking about it, back here on the guitar, on a takeoff style, sometimes we wish that he would, Wendell Mercantile and his piles of styles. And on the steel guitar, big welcome wherever you are, Mr. Waldo Otto.
Chocolate.
Waldo and his brother Elmo. Otto on the fiddle, Elmo Otto, ladies and gentlemen, on the fiddle. Plays a fine fiddle, and he plays it mighty fine.
You know, Red, I just, there are some really interesting vendors around here. Apart from this nice young man that gave me these fresh donuts, I bought these nifty glasses for $25. And they really work, you know, they're supposed to be three-dimensional. And everything looks like it's real, you know, like in three dimensions, you know, like, whoa! It looked like it was coming right at me, see?
All right, Waldo Otto and Elmo Otto, Wendell Mercantile, but back on the bass, the guy you don't know a lot about, and neither do we. He was born just out of wedlock, Montana. Grew up in filth, Montana. Now lives in Greece. Not the city, just the stuff. He's got a lot of hobbies. He likes to tie flies. In fact, and has nothing to do with fishing. He just gets regular house flies and ties them up. Please make him welcome. His name is Slade. Brand new one by Slade. It's called Cold and Damp. Slade. Thank you, Slade.
You want more of those donuts, Waldo?
Well, all right, I think it's time for Wendell Mercantile to perform one on his piles of styles. guitar. Here it is. One featuring the surf style along with the Clint Eastwood and American Indian style. Hope you enjoy one called Apache. Mm-hmm.
I'll back it up.
Don't you think?
Yeah!
Well, let him know! Yeah! He'll do it again if you really want him to. Yeah! Okay, we want you to.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. I'm ready. I'm going to do it right now. I gotta wait.
Don't smile.
Playing the mercantile on the old takeoff style. Hey. All right, thank you very much. Playing the mercantile. We're going to do one more song and then we have to finish the show a little. We're going to do another one.
That is our leader.
Have your guitar turned off or something. Jeez, yeah, that was really good for a while.
Brand new, too.
Jeez, what happened?
You must have broke it.
Jeez, what a shame. Yeah, just play the banjo.
Yeah, that would be really thing. Good.
Nobody can turn it off or break it. Well, all right, before we play another song, I'd like to have Waldo come up and tell you about the donuts at this time. Here comes Waldo with an ad for his special store in Wyoming, Montana. Waldo is just about donuts.
Thank you very much, Red and Elmo. Yeah, Elmo's just demonstrating what you could do with a fresh donut. I don't know too much about that. The young man who brought those up to us, they were fresh, you know. I was holding it, and it sort of started moving in my hand, and I realized it's because the donut material is actually soft. And I'm not that familiar with that sort of donut. Now, I know a lot of you are thinking in this time of inflation, they're thinking, yes, the bluegrass and everything, but how do I save, while still getting to eat lots of donuts? That's the big question. I don't know, did they have that in the skywriting here earlier today? A lot of people have been asking that, and of course, the answer is, just come on up to my store, Waldo's Discount Donuts, where we've got all kind of donuts, like chocolate. And they're a variety of ages. We have your fairly old and you have your incredibly old and your archaeology donuts, which are amazing. And those you could use for a weapon if you had to. Excuse me? Oh. Anyway, yes, that's right, we're running out of time. But we're not running out of donuts, so we'll see you up there. You know, and don't forget, of course, the automato. You can say it with me if you like. You bite it!
You bought it!
Thank you, Waldo. Waldo just got down, just down the street from the Eat Cafe in Wyoming, Montana. Thank you very much. Well, we're going to do one more, and We really enjoyed playing for you. This is one called Long Gone John from Bowling Green. Some of you know the words, some of you don't. So those of you that know the words, sing along, and those of you who don't, learn them. This is, it goes, Long Gone from Kentucky. Long gone, ain't he lucky? Long gone, that's what I mean. He's Long Gone John from Bowling Green. And it will be revealed what the words really mean.
Just watch me, I know it.
Ready? Come on. Yesterday, you know that fool already made his getaway. He's long gone
from Kentucky.
Long gone,
ain't he lucky?
Long gone, that's what I mean. He's long gone, John from Bowling Green. Oh, when you got it, working time. Man I ever met, like to flirt with all the pretty gals that he'd see, and he got mixed up with some policeman's wife, and now he's left his husband night. He's long gone
from Kentucky,
long gone,
hey, he lucky,
long gone, that's what I mean, he's long gone John from Bowling Green. By the name of Peck, he fell in a well and he broke his neck. Deserves him right, cause he should have been home. Take it to sick and leave it well alone. He's long gone
from Kentucky.
Long gone.
Ain't he lucky?
He's long gone, that's what I mean. He's long gone, John from Bowling Green. Actually, right now, I'm going to say bye-bye for now because I'm Red Knuckles.
Hey, we're the Trailblazers!
Featuring Wendell Mercantile on the guitar. Bass, everybody's favorite slave. I'm Red Knuckles.
And we're the Trailblazers!
We're the Trailblazers! We're gonna say bye-bye for now. Bye-bye, y'all. Thank you. Thank you, country music fans and bluegrass fans too. Hot Rod will be right back.
How about that, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ray Decker? What a beautiful crowd you are. Red just said so. Mr. Red Becker, Mr. Hockey Talk Man, Mr. She's My Baby, She's Going Steady with Me.
Slade Walk.
Would you like to hear Red do another number?
Yeah!
I can't hear you! And Webb said, there stands the glass. But it wasn't a glass, it was just little red knuckles. And Webb took him and said, here is how to sing. And Red learned how to sing that way as he grew up. And he learned how to cipher. And he learned how to watch TV. And then when he was older, he met us. And of course, as you know, the rest is mystery.
Thank you, Waldo.
That's the story of Red Knuckles, available on our next long-playing 78 record.
Do you have any requests out there, ladies and gentlemen?
Slade Walk!
Okay. That's enough. Okay, let's do those.
Sit down. You're blocking those people's view.
Hank, how do you like them?
That's bluegrass. That's the one song that Red knows in bluegrass. How about If You Ain't Loving, Red? That's a good number. That's a message.
If you ain't loving, you ain't living. That's a good. That's a true song. It's a true song from Farron Young. Is that his real name, Farron Young's?
Is that whose real name?
All right. It's the first time anyone's ever laughed at that joke.
Well, it's about time. If you people would all explain it to all the rest of the people we've told that to, we'd appreciate it.
All right, here we go. If you got a Cadillac, boy, and a 40-room shack, boy, and a bucket full of mileage, and a tree full of honey, but if you get no boogin', no smoochin' or a buggin', you ain't lovin', you ain't livin'. If you're riding on a gravy train, instead of walking down Lover's Lane, you can't make it, boy, that don't run away, boy. But it takes a little honey, it's better than money. If you ain't loving, then you ain't living. Smoking them four-bit cigars ain't so well to do, but as you get a little coochie-coo, it takes a little smacking. Your life it is lacking. If you ain't loving, then you ain't living. Thank you.
baby train, instead of walking down Lover's Lane. You can't make it, boy, you're going the wrong way, boy. It takes a little honey, she's better than money. If you ain't loving, then you ain't living, brother. Thanks, folks. Please enjoy it. I'd rather be right back. Special thanks to Elmo Otto on the field.
Big, and that's what the Trailblazers is all about. Thank you, friends. We'll see you next time. Don't forget to watch. If you do come through Wyoming, Montana, one of the things I'm thinking about starting up is Wendell Museum, you know, just things, various pictures of myself and different things like clothing I might have worn and different guitars and stuff, and maybe a few of my little sayings. There might even be little framed things, pages from some of the first, only actually original pages of the book Wendell Mercantile's Piles of Styles might be on exhibit there.
Yeah, we have some of your socks in the back room too, you can probably.
Well, I hadn't thought about putting them in, but maybe that'd be all right. Anyway, thanks, okay, friends. And I do want to say to all the people out here in California, you can just be, you know, the witnesses here for me to say this, which is I do appreciate all the things that Hot Rize has sort of done in the way of getting us to different places where we can play in front of so many people and kind of get around the country. They've helped us, you know, kind of leave where we were from and get over to other parts of the country and get to play for all the people here. You know, you don't have to like their music, you don't even have to like them, but you got to like what they've done for the Trailblazers.
All right. Get off the stage. Aren't they wonderful? Wendell Mercantile, the spokesman for the group.
Sort of band workshops and things, and breaking up has really turned out to be a great thing for a band's career. Good idea. April Fool's, it is April Fool's, I can tell. We're gonna play the song now.
Thank you. Is terrible. I can double my money. I can make $100 in 10 minutes here, instead of in a week and a half. And of course I did lose it all, but no, I think I kept 30. So I have that 20. I guess I have the 20. Stuart Duncan and Sally Van Meter, give them a hand. Welcome to the We're going to leave you with a bluegrass standard. Once again, thanks to Frank Edmondson and all the organizers and volunteers and sponsors of the Bluegrass Festival Santa Maria Style.
Dobro and Fiddle Duet.
Thank you. Maybe, does anybody know how to play the saw? That would be good. Trio. Ready? Thanks again. Here's one called Shuckin' the Corn.
got our best. We got Pete Running on the banjo, Charles Hotel on the guitar, Nick Bush on the bass, I'm Neil O'Brien, and our special guests are Stuart Duncan and Sally Van Meter. Thanks.
Show me.